Welcome to Your Voice. I'm Julia Lilkindy. Today, Senator John Bonacic is here to talk about protecting taxpayer dollars and vital programs. How are you, Senator?
Good, Julie. Very good. You know, there is a subject that's close to my heart, and that is a piece of legislation by Senator Libous, which I have co-sponsored, which eliminates fraud and abuse in the social services area. Mm-hmm. Today, if people are up against it, they get a benefit card from the state of New York that looks something like this. Looks a little bit like a driver's license when you look at it. Now, when you get this benefit card, it's usually given to people that may be unemployed or they're struggling to make ends meet. And $400 for a family of four goes for food stamps, which they can use in the food market, and they get $800 cash, and the $800 cash is intended to help the families with basic necessities to survive, to pay the rent, if they have children, maybe to buy clothes, buy toothpaste, they need aspirins or whatever. And what we're finding is that $800 cash is being used for purposes that it was never intended for. What do I mean? I mean, the person who has the benefit card and gets the cash, the head of the household, whether it's the man or the woman, they go and they buy beer, they buy liquor, they buy cigarettes, they gamble, they go to the lottery. They go to strip clubs. They go to various casinos. And they spend the money for the purpose that it was never intended for. Now, Senator Libous has been persistent. We've passed the legislation 2 years in a row. And don't ask me why, but the Assembly never moves on the bill. And it's an awful lot of money. If I recall, it's close to $4 million a month that is going for this abuse, fraud, and waste. Now, this $4 million could go to those poor people that are struggling for the legitimate purposes of food and clothing for the children and paying the rent. Why would we ever want to protect that group of people that are using this card for selfish reasons, not for the family for which it was intended for, and depriving those other groups that are up against it from having necessary resources and they're trying to do the right thing? So, this is something that we are trying to correct, and the Assembly has not moved on it. And we're coming to a deadline, mm-hmm. I believe it's February 22nd,
right,
where the federal government is saying that you're gonna lose $122 million. Now, Governor Cuomo has put in his executive budget this language to make it happen, to eliminate this abuse, but that may be near the end of March or April 1st. And I'm not sure if we can get an extender of that deadline from the federal government. So that $122 million is at risk. So the Assembly has between now and February 22nd to still act and do the responsible thing. And we had a press conference today, and we had a woman who told about her suffering, and she addressed this subject.
Yeah, she was a business owner. She was a former recipient of welfare, and she agrees with you that there needs to be more accountability in the system. Let's take a look at that.
Okay.
Years ago, I went through a difficult time in my life, and I used public assistance to help me buy food and pay for things in my day-to-day life. I also spent a lot of that money on things that I shouldn't have, and I know firsthand the gaping holes in our public assistance programs. As a business owner, I can tell you it has been harder for me now than it was when everything was handed to me with no accountability. Without regulations as to where welfare benefits can be spent, there is no holding a person accountable for their purchases while on welfare, never ensuring that the helping hand that public assistance is becomes a lifestyle.
So there is a difference between help and a handout.
Absolutely. And it's all about accountability, responsibility, giving children in the family who are old enough to see how their parents or parent is behaving, so they don't fall into the wrong mindset and keep this going from one generation to the other.
Right. You just talked about that. You came here right from session and you voted on the floor. Let's take a look at that right now.
Okay. It's hard for me to understand the justification on how anyone could keep supporting those individuals that commit fraud and waste for a very good purpose, where people need basic necessities in life, and you deprive those that are in the greatest need of getting that money. I saw some of the records. There's over close to $9 million of this abuse being spent outside the state of New York with this benefit card, in Vegas, in Atlantic City, out in California. And when we talk about we're hurting the children, I think the children in a household watch what their parents do. They learn, or either properly or not properly, by the actions of their parents. And if parents are committing fraud and waste and no accountability, then the children are going to get the wrong message. So, and the other thing that's disturbing is that the federal government has said, if the assembly does not pass this legislation by February 22nd, the state loses $122 million of federal funds. Now, that's scary for the assembly not to act. I don't understand their mindset in not addressing this very important issue that Senator Libous puts forward. In the budget proposal of Governor Cuomo, there is language that corrects this for the assembly's failure to act, but I don't know if the federal government will accept a delay that we don't meet that deadline. So I'm hopeful that Governor Cuomo, acting like a responsible adult and not wanting to lose the $122 million, and when we have a budget on time, this problem will be cured, and hopefully we would have saved the state taxpayers $122 million. Julie, there is a trend that I see happening not only at the state level for certain elected officials, but even at the federal level, and that is these entitlement handouts, bigger government, and income inequality the president talks about all the time. But when you give somebody a helping hand, an entitlement, America has always been generous. We are a nation of compassion. So when we help someone, we don't say that with this handout, you don't have to be responsible. You don't have to be accountable. And there is a mindset of elected officials that want to be enablers or entitlement without having accountability or responsibility of the one receiving the benefits. That's wrong, that's dangerous. And I think many of the members of the assembly who now, so far, the third year, failure to act on this, they say, well, I don't care. We're helping a portion of our constituency that needs it. If they want to abuse it, it's okay. They want to commit waste and fraud, it's okay. It's not okay. Because there's another group of constituency that are in the same economic level, that are poor, that need this help. And if these resources dry up for them, because of the fraud and waste, we have done a major disservice to the people of this state.
Right, so the federal mandate said by February 22nd, or we'll lose $122 million, and then that's taxpayers footing that.
Right, but I have to give the federal government credit, because they've put this punitive measure in to make, really, the elected officials, a portion of them anyway, the majority, in the assembly, to act and act quickly, so the recipient, the message is sent to the recipient. If you're going to take this money, you got to be accountable, you got to be responsible, not only to yourself, but to your family.
Hopefully this gets resolved.
I hope so, Julie.